I remember back in the early 70s, some of the Hapkido masters we trained with, they were told this, you know, sort of 3,000 technique, sort of 3,000 technique. And then when you learn, if you open your eyes and your mind, you realize that some of those techniques are the same. Mm-hmm. Same technique, whether you do it this side or left side or right side, or whether you do it on your knees or from behind, same technique. Okay? So it's not that many. My teacher decided he would do 12 and into 24. So you have 24 technique. But you start with 12. Okay? So don't get confused, because you get thinking that you're practicing a different technique. It's the same technique. Whether it's a different angle, give me an example. This wrist throw, old school Hapkido, when we did this throw, we projected this. Close, right? So that means it was no continuation. See? So this way, when you guy, he's there now. See? So there's a continuation of your movements, even from the time that you put him over on his back, you can still pick him up.
Yes,
see? So that means your movements continue, and you can keep going on and on forever with the technique. And that's what you want to think, because like I said earlier, before we started, this is one blow. It's not necessarily going to end the fight. If you fight, get lucky. If you hit him right here,
yes,
hit him right there, he might go out, right?
Yes,
maybe not. Some people are really tough, right? Okay, we're going to do same one hand.